In this video, I will show you how to use RFPro HFSS option on a 4G amplifier. You can see here the top test bench of the design, and when pushing into the symbol, one can look at the schematic version of the amplifier. If we run the simulation, this is the kind of results we'll get with roughly 17 dB of gain, centered around 7 GHz. Now, let's take into account the EM effects. We first start by opening the layout of the amplifier and create an RFPro view. RFPro is the platform on which we will make all our EM simulations. As you can see, it has a 3D view, but it also keeps all the components nets that are present in the original layout. That allows to partition what you want to simulate at EM level and what you want to keep at circuit level. In this case, everything is passive except the FET, so we'll select all but the FET to be sent to the EM simulation by choosing a layout role. Once the partitioning is done, let's jump to the analysis part and give an appropriate name to the analysis. As for every EM simulation, we need ports to excite the structure, and we can use the layout pins, and RFPro will automatically convert them into ports, refer to the closest ground reference it finds as displayed here. Then, we will indicate that there are components that do not belong to the EM simulation, as the M1 FET here, and we will add it to the components part of the analysis. Later, you will see that RFPro will reconnect the transistors pins automatically to the EM simulation. Then, we need to set up the solver. On top of Keysight Momentum and 3D FEM, RFPro now hosts ANSYS HFSS as a registered solver, and we will use HFSS in this simulation. First, let's add a linear sweep to indicate to HFSS how many points it should create in the final S-parameter file. To use the HFSS solver, one just needs to select the ANSYS HFSS solver in the simulator pane. Then, if you click on the gear icon, you will have access to some HFSS options directly from the RFPro interface, such as the convergence error criterion or the refinement frequency. Let's change one. The bold font indicates that the value is different from the default settings. That's all. Nothing more is needed besides launching the simulation. All other information, substrate, geometry, ports, will be sent from RFPro to HFSS, and HFSS will then simulate the input, and the simulation log, as you see, is displayed live in the RFPro environment. Once the simulation is over, RFPro fetches the results and converts them into its own format. Then one can display and post-process the data inside RFPro using predefined functions or Python code, or if preferred, use them with the ADS data display. But the intent for every circuit designer is to go back to circuit simulation to assess the results in the context of the real circuit. RFPro can then generate a schematic view that will consist of the ports, the HFSS S-parameters file, and the components left at the circuit role. Everything is, of course, already rewired to avoid any manual step. Now, all is ready to simulate the top-level circuit of this amplifier with the EM effects computed by HFSS in RFPro. Simply select the view that we've just created and run the simulation. Now, to compare the results between the schematic and the EM views, let's turn on the history mode, and you can see the bold blue results for the EM simulation and the red from the schematic simulation. As a summary, you can now seamlessly use ANSYS HFSS inside RFPro without any export or manual steps. Just make your partitioning, choose your EM solver, and run your simulation. Thanks for watching.